Hello, everyone. Happy Wednesday to you all, and thanks for joining me this morning. I love these Wednesday lives, and I've got a really fun project for you, as always. And I'm in the Christmas mode, so I've got a Christmas snowy project for you. But for those of you who live in the warm climate, I mean, I haven't forgotten you. I just am into these snowy scenes lately. But I am doing a Southwest Christmas next one on YouTube. So if you live in that warm climate, be sure and check out that video. I'll show you the project at the end so you can have something to look forward to. So, okay, you guys, I see you coming on here. So I'm getting my iPad set up. So tell me you are on. I see Kathy and Jill. Thanks, you guys. I've got Kim on here. So as always, there's somebody on here to answer your questions, and I am trying to do better at that. Georgia's on. Hello, Georgia. Hi from Puyallup, Linda, Teresa, Gail from Georgia. Hello, Dorothy from Wisconsin. Hi to all of you. Thanks for spending your morning with me. I look forward to this so much. Carol, hello. Jill is on our design team, and holy cow, is she talented. In fact, I got to show you a sample of hers that I've got right here, but I can, you know, our design team are the most talented people, and Jill is one of them. She is really something. So I got to show you guys that. Debbie Hedges from Salem, the Netherlands. Wow. So it's probably not in the morning there. What time is it in the Netherlands? Roberta, hello. Kathy from Texas, from Michigan. Hi to all of you guys. Thanks for joining me. From Alabama. Isn't this so cool? We can watercolor together, you guys. I just love it. And hopefully you will, all those of you who ordered our new watercolor release, you should have gotten that in the mail. And thank you so much for your patience with us on that. We are trying to get that under control now. And I think we've gotten that worked out now so that we've got our supply chain back to normal, and we don't have this happen again. But thank you so much for hanging in there with us. That was a long wait, but they really are. These things are so much fun. I'm going to use some of them today in our little project. So hi from Holland. Wow. Jill, I love being on the design team. Well, we love having you. You are such a talent. Belgium, hello. North Carolina, hello from Michigan. Wow. Dawn from New York. Wow. Hi, Ruth Ann. Hi, Karen. Hi, Deborah. Oh, just got our new stamps. Great, great. That's awesome. So I think Kim is on here. I think Phil is going to pop on here. So let's get going. It's 10:02 right now. So actually, let's just give another minute for everyone to get on. But in the meantime, those of you who haven't seen, let me show you our newest release this week. So this is our Cubby line. So I don't know if you guys are familiar with Cubby line. It's one of our most popular lines. And what these are stamps, large stamps, and then they come with all the little dies, and the dies open the doors and the windows and all of that. And let me just show you. So here's the little fairy set. Let me show you this one first. This is just so cute. It's got all these little fairies. So the dies and the stamps are included in here. This is probably backwards, but you get the idea. So you can see all the little doors and stuff that open up here. And this is Jill's card. Is this just the cutest thing? I just love the way she colored this. I love these little fairies. They're so cute and really fun to do. And you know what? Kids love these projects because they're really, you know, it's really fun to create these things. So the large die cuts out the basic image here and then opens the doors and the windows. And then all of these little fairies also have dies that cut them out. So the stamp set is actually, it's actually pretty big. So it's a 4x6 set, and we just jam as much as we can in here. There are lots of sentiments. This one says, hope your day is magical, sparkle, make a wish, fairy princess, wishing you a very happy birthday. So really, really fun. Jammed full of stamps. And then, of course, the dies. And these are all full body dies. So that's the thing about the cubbies, is that you can use these for lots of different other different cards, because it's not just a head poking out of a window. It's actually the whole body. So, and here is the other one. This is the little birds. Oh, let me show you one more card here. So this one is from Crystal, who is also an amazing talent, Crystal Schneider. And she is an amazing talent. Like, I'm so impressed with their coloring and the way they put these together. Isn't that cute? Just so cute. So talented. And this is the other one. So this one's called the Birdhouse Cubby Set. And it comes with all these little birds. Also comes with this vine. So you can put the vine and the little flowers just all around the birdhouse. And just so, so cute. This one also comes with a bunch of sentiments. It's just loaded. It's a 4x6 set. You can see the large stamp here with all the openings. And then the die cuts out all the openings and all the doors. And then it's just fun to tuck all these little things in there. Just so cute. So let me show you these cards. This one's by Jessica. Isn't this cute? I just love the way she colored this. Jessica Shire, she's also on our design team. Isn't that cute? And this one, it doesn't say, but I think this is probably Renee's card. This looks like her. And she has been with us a long, long time, Renee Matteries. And she is a phenomenal talent. Just a phenomenal talent. We're so thankful for these girls. They are just amazing. So, okay, you guys, it's 10:05. Are we ready to get started on a project? This is a watercolor project. It is a snowy project, and I am going to use one of the simple scenes. So I'm going to use this one, and the reason I chose this one is because I want to use a large stamp with it. So I've, in the release, I've got a little village with a lot of little houses and things that you can put together as a little village, but you can also use your big stamps. And so I want to show you how to do that. And what I've done is I've chosen this set, which I haven't used in a long time. So this little covered bridge, and we're going to use this covered bridge with that little creek. So I want you to see how versatile these things are and to try your larger images. And I am going to do more tutorials on the small little structures, but you are not limited to the small structures. You can use a large structure like this one. And that's part of the reason I chose the creek, is because I am using the covered bridge. But the other ones would also work. So here actually is the project that we're going to do. So what I did was I took the windows out of the covered bridge, and I put the little wreaths on there, and then I put that little covered bridge above that creek. So it's really, really simple, and I am loving this tree. So I'm going to put this tree back in. Those of you who saw the project on Watercolor Wednesday on YouTube saw me do this tree, but I just love it so much, because it's really hard to get a realistic snowy tree. It really is. To make it look like it's an actual snowy tree in the background, it's really hard to get that. But I think this is the easiest way to do it. So I'm going to show you one more time how to do that. And then, I don't know if you can see, but I've got a bunch of sparkles on here, and, I don't know if you can see that. Actually, see it on the video. So, that being said, let's get going on the project. And then at the end, I will come back at the end and make sure that if there are questions that you want to ask me. I'll try to kind of watch my phone too, but I'll see if there are any questions at the end that maybe you have a question about. We're going to use the mask pen. So, okay, you guys ready? Let me switch my camera around. So always thank you for bearing with me on this part to make sure I get this on here without cutting myself off. Okay, and I want to make sure this is large enough that you can see. And I've got my palette. So I don't need a ton of markers. You know, when you're doing these snowy scenes, you don't need a lot. And really, you're kind of focusing on, one main element. Now, in this case, it's really two. But here's your basic image that you're really focusing on. So everything around it can be pretty simple as far as texture and color. So that's kind of what we're doing here. We're making this really simple. And then I want to show you how to do a half riff like this. So where you've got the snow kind of melting off a little bit, this is really, really fun to do. And it's not hard. It's actually really simple. So I want to show you this tree one more time. I want to show you this. And on YouTube, I should have written down who asked me this, but someone made a comment and said, it would be really fun to have a little red bird. And I love that idea. And so here we go, a little red bird. So I'm going to show you how to do all of this. Now, I'm still using my prototypes because I don't have my stamps yet either. And I do hope that I will be getting them soon. But I am using prototypes, which are rubber, for some of these. So I'll explain that to you when I go. So here's what we're going to do. Here's what we're going to need. So we are going to need the covered bridge, this one right here. We're going to use that. And we are going to use this simple scene. So this is a the Stone Creek scene, and we're going to use this. Now, we're not going to use this whole thing because we are using a large image. So we're putting this large image onto this scene. So we don't need this background here at all. And actually, we're going to stop the lines right here. So we're only going to ink this part of the stamp. I want you to see how versatile these things are and give it a try. You're not locked into what's showing on the scene. There are lots and lots of different ways to use these. And that's really what I think about when I put them together. I really think about how they can be used and how they can be used with things that you already have. I love that things are versatile, and I love that you can go back to your stamp sets, even if they're older stamp sets, and bring them out and use them with the things that are new. So that's what I want to show you today. So I am going to my new mini foliage set. I love this set so much. Now on my scene here, I don't have these two yet. I don't have prototypes of these two yet. So I'm using something else. But if I had these, I would definitely use these. And I would use this little thing too in the background. So in the meantime, we're only going to use this little section here to create this background, these background trees. So just this one right here. So I am using this one because I don't have those, and this one. So these two from the branches set, we're going to use these two. So what I'm saying too is things are versatile. If you don't have a specific set that I'm showing, chances are pretty good that you have something that you can use. And even some of these smaller branches, you know, if you're going to make a little tree in the background, you know, like this, you can make do with something like these. If you don't have that, or you're not in a position to buy a new set right now, turn this little thing upside down and use something like this as a tree in the background. So there are ways that you can improvise. So we're going to use that. And then for that snowy tree, we're going to use this one. Now you can use some of these other fir boughs too. I think this is the easiest one to do, but by all means, try experimenting. And this is a snowy tree we're going to use. We're going to use this as a pattern into the background, and then we're going to make our little snowy tree over the top. So the little bird, I am using this tiny, tiny little bird here because I am making this really small scene. But you can bring this forward and use a smaller bird too. So it's just bringing it forward into the foreground, which will be larger than what is back here. So you can use that too. So I'm using this tiny little tree from this, or tiny little bird from this set. And then in here, the mini flower set, this little guy right here to make that wreath. So we are going to make this wreath into the background here. We're just going to create this little wreath, and we're going to use that one little stamp and just kind of work it around in a circle. So I'm going to show you how to make all of that and do all of that. So let's get going here. We're going to start out with that basic, with the basic set. Or the basic image, and that is this guy right here. Now, this is rubber, so if you've gotten this set, you have gotten the clear, and I do think the clear is easier to position, and that's why some of these are clear now. I've gone to clear. I'm really happy with the quality of the product, and I do think it's easier to place it and see where it's going. So, you know, in that case, I do feel like the clear is better, and if you're stamping it over and over again and you're using it as foliage or flowers, it's going to be rubber every time, because if you're stamping it over and over, you got to keep that ink onto the rubber and get multiple impressions. Okay, so I hope that clarifies. So let's get going on here. I'm going to stamp this now in two colors. And remember, we're leaving this section off. So we're not going to do anything with this background here. We're going to leave that off because we do have a large image. And you know what? It would just cover all of this anyway. So we're just going to do the foreground here of this little creek. And we're going to do it in two colors.
So we're going to use the 969 and the 565. So I'm going to, just to make it simple, I'm going to start out with the blue. And actually, now I just did exactly what I said I wasn't going to do. Okay, so take this off with your finger. And we're just going to do this area here. So just this part in the front. And I'm getting this area where the water is. And I'm just getting these little rocks and this area right here. And then I'm just going to go over with the dark brown. I'm just going to go over the rocks only. So not this area where the creek is, but just where the rocks are. Okay, so I'm going to just stamp this off a little bit. I don't want it too dark. And then I'm going to stamp it on my paper just a little bit off center. So like this. That's exactly where we want it. So let me make sure I get this into the screen. So if you see me going off the screen, you guys, I try to really pay attention to that. But if you see me going off the screen, be sure to comment on here so I don't do that. Okay, I think we're good. So let's go ahead now and let's go on and place our bridge, our covered bridge. So I'm going to now also do this in two colors. So I'm going to do the blue first. I'm going to do the roof. So this whole roof line is going to be blue, and we're going to color everything now except for the windows. We don't want to ink those in. And we're going to go back over this now with the brown, but not where the roof is. So I'll show you when we get to that. So I'm just doing the rocks here. Now I'm really avoiding this little grass line here. And if you think you've hit some of it, just take your finger and just run it across here. And don't get the grassy area. So I'm just getting all of this. If you get a tiny bit of the windows, it's okay. You know, we're going to cover it up with the wreaths anyway, so no worries about that. Don't get any of this area where the pathway is. Don't get any of this. Just the rocks here and the structure. And then I'm going to go over it again now with the dark brown. So here's the dark brown. Not the roof, because that's going to be mostly snowy, but this area here where the door is, the side of the structure, and for sure the rocks down under here. We're going to really get this area. And again, make sure you don't get that grassy area. And then I would just, run my finger along here just to make sure that I didn't pick up any of that. And that looks pretty good. We've got the windows separate. And I, of course, I'm going to use my positioner. We just can't take a chance with this. So I'm going to place this into the center here so that I can see where it's going. Now, do you see where this little point is? We're going to connect that right here to this slope. We're just going to connect that onto here, just like that, and place this over the top. Do you see how that creek is now running underneath that little bridge? And this is why we don't want those that grassy area to show either. So now I'm going to place this in here. Huff on it. And then just stamp it right in here. And don't press too hard. You know, you don't want it too dark on here. Okay, so now you can see where that creek is going underneath here. And actually, we're going to turn it and use a pencil, to do this. So we're going to actually turn this around and just put a line right here in the back. And then this line here, do you see how this line comes up here? This is just going to come all the way up here. And so will this. So will this come up here. And when you put these lines in, it kind of helps you see a little bit where everything is going. So you can see now how the creek comes around, and it just helps your eye to see how to place everything together. Okay? And then the background, we'll tackle the background later. So right now we're going to place our tree here. We're going to start pulling the color out of the lines here and work on our little bridge for now. So let's do that. So I've got my water. I'm going to place it over here so that you guys can see. Actually, I'm going to place it over here so my palette is over here. Okay, so I'm going to dip my brush. and really get it saturated. You know, the first time you use it, you want to make sure you get enough water in here so that you can really get enough water onto your project. So I'm going to come under here just like this and just pull this color out of the lines. And just start, this is the first step. You never have to worry too much about this because we're going to just come back later and add more detail in here. So this is just the first step. You know, this is inside here, now inside this little bridge. So this is going to be a little bit darker, you know, including this side here that's going to be in the shadow. And then the rocks, you're still going to see a highlight on here. So remember with things that are contoured, if it's a dome, and it's a dome over the top, that highlight is going to be at the top. If it's a contour like this and rounded, it's going to be in the center. So we still want to see that highlight in the center of these rocks. Never want to color rocks in solid. They will look flat and you won't be happy with them. So just a little bit of color. If you can just, you know, kind of train yourself not to color things in solidly. We can come back and add a little more color in here too. Okay, so let's tackle this roof now. So I'm going to show you how to do a little roof that where the snow is kind of melting. So I've got my pencil again, and I'm just going to make a little, you know, kind of an S curve like this. And actually, you can do something like this too, where you can actually show this corner. You know, and then we're gonna erase this line afterwards. So you don't ever have to worry about that. Okay, so now we're gonna take some blue and we're gonna put it onto our palette. This is the dark blue. And this is the most versatile color. It's the 565. I use it all the time and it makes a great snow color. It makes a great shadow color. It just works great for everything. So I am now going to take some of this color and just kind of follow this line around. Now, when you follow the line and you make a kind of a bank here, you can see how that just popped the snow up. This is just how you do it. It's not hard. You just want to draw a line along that edge, and that's going to bring this up. You know, it's going to be a little darker on the bottom, and you can see how that just popped that snow right up. And then let's just put a little darker color in here and in here. Okay, so now I'm gonna add some color now to the roof, and I'm gonna just use a, you know, just a simple brown. This is a 947. You can use this brown. You can also add some brown like this one to it and mix and get a different color. So I'm just gonna mix these two together and just brush this on. When you're doing a roof, never color all the way to the top. You always want to see a highlight up there. And actually it's better if you can just see a little, some areas of white. Okay, so we don't have to do a lot here. Just put a little more color on here and then we're gonna just put some detail in. And I'm gonna take my fine tip now. This is my fine tip brown, it's my twin tone. And I'm just gonna really darken this area here. And you can see how that will just pop things up. And under here. So I'm gonna make a few little lines with my dark brown, just to add some texture and detail. Since we're showing this roof, it's kind of fun to show some detail on it. And then, you know, maybe a few little individual boards like this would be good. And then underneath this snow, you know, it's going to be a little darker under here. And that's all you have to do. Now you can take some of this, you know, on the top and pull some of this color up. And that will also make this look whiter. Because you know, we've got this blue line up here, but the top of the roof, you know, where the sun is, you know, where it's shining, this is going to be really white here. Very, very white. So let's take some of this blue now. And I'm going to brush some blue in on this side because this is where the shadow side is. When you've got a structure like this, you just have to choose a light side and a dark side. And it's going to be much easier to do the dark side over here. So one side is going to be in the shadow. And this could, you know, just keep building this color up a little bit. You know, it's gonna be a shadow here. And then we'll come back in and do a little pathway and stuff here too. Okay, so now let's do our little wreaths. And I'm gonna use a pencil and I'm just gonna make my circles. I'll start with the one in the center and then I'll make another one over here and then another one over here. And just make them rough just so that you have a basic size. And then again, you know, we're going to erase these lines, so you don't have to worry if they're just perfect or not. So I'm going to turn it like this, and I'm going to get my green. So I'm going to use this green right here. This is the number 177, and my tiny, tiny little flower that's in the flower set. So it's this one right here. We're going to use that. And I'm just going to work my way around. Now put this in the center or in the corner. It's going to be much easier to place like that. If you put it in the center of your block, you're gonna have a hard time trying to place it. But when you put it up here in the corner, it's just much easier to see where it's going. And you can actually tap it in here a few times before you have to re-ink it. And it just makes a really cute little wreath. And just, you know, turn your paper, you know, move it around so that it's easier for you to stamp this. And it doesn't, you know, it doesn't have to be perfect. You know, I probably say that in every video. It doesn't have to be perfect. You know, people don't look at these and think, oh, wow, that leaf is, you know, kind of off-centered. Nobody thinks that. They just can't believe that you created something this beautiful and that you're such an amazing artist, and then you spent all this time making something just for them. Like, it really encourages people. And you know what? People need to be encouraged. They really do. People are struggling for whatever reason. And, you know, whatever the reason is, you know, we are together. We are people that care about each other, and we want to encourage. Want to encourage anyone who's hurting. And, you know, something that you've spent time on like this, you've created something beautiful to give away. It just does something for people. And they, you know, they for sure would never throw this away. Okay, so we've got our little wreaths on here. Now, don't be intimidated by the bows. Now, I just did some little bows on here. Nothing to it. Don't be intimidated by that. And I put some little berries on. So I took my fine tip here with the red, and this is just a, you know, simple red. And I just put a few little berries in just to give it a little more color. And, you know, try to keep them in the white. They're going to show up much better. So just like this. And then I just put in a little, you know, bow, almost like a little star, and call it good. So now let's go on and add some texture into the side here, because I really think that's fun to do. And I'm just gonna take my, I'm just gonna take a little ruler and I'm gonna make some pencil lines here. Make sure I'm in the center of the screen. And I'm just going to kind of go in between with my pencil and then just drop it down. And just keep going. You can change the look of this so much by just, you know, changing out the detail like this. It's really fun. Whoops, I forgot the insides. Let me go up and do that. So up one more notch. And let's get the inside of the wreath there. And then let's come down. These don't have to be perfect. You know, you don't have to measure each one. Just kind of eyeball it. And, you know, when it comes to stuff like this, I am so not a perfectionist. I just do it the easy way. And I think if it's not perfect, it's fine. It's absolutely fine. So now I'm going to take this gray. This is a very, very light gray, N89. Now, I've used this before with the Simple Scenes by putting in the background. It doesn't matter which gray you use, just something light, really, really light. Now, you can see on the palette how light this is. You can hardly see the color at all, but it makes a great shadow for a detail like this. So I'm just going to use the fine tip, and I'm just going to go right underneath these little slats. Just right underneath. And again, you know, it doesn't have to be perfect. It's just the idea of things. Okay, how cute is that? So I'm gonna take my fine tip, my little blue, and I can see I wanna add a little more color into the rocks here, especially into these little crevices. And you can see the difference. So let me do it on this side, and then I'll show you the difference between this side and the other just by doing this. And then I'm going to take my brown and do the same. And I'm just going to add a little bit more in here and under here. And you can, I don't know if you can see that really clear on here, but see how much more detailed this looks? You know, and it's all about making it look realistic to me. I don't ever want this to look like it's a stamp. I don't want anyone to think that you stamped this. I want them to think that you painted it. And really, you have. You have painted it. So now you can pull out just a little bit more of this color, just like that. Now see the difference there? You can really see that these little rocks over on this side look a little more realistic. Now we want to come in here and get a little shadow on this side. So these little stones that are kind of underneath, we want to show a shadow. Show a shadow. That was a tongue twister. You can see a shadow on this side. So we're going to do the same over here. So we're going to start out by putting in those tiny little crevices with our fine tip. Just in the corners where you see that these rocks kind of come together and stack on top of each other. Just put a little more color in, especially under here. Think about, you know, if this covered bridge were sitting on top of these rocks, you know, you would have quite a shadow under here. And you see this angle? So we're seeing the angle of the covered bridge. We're going to see the angle also of the rocks. Does that make sense? And then to pull some of this color out, just like this, so easy. And then the shadow underneath here. And then I'm just gonna put a little darker color now under here. And what that does is it just looks like this roof is hanging over a little farther. Same over here. You can really make this side now a little darker. Okay? And, you know, you could just come under here just a little bit and put a little shadow under this wreath, just a little bit of blue underneath. So let me hold that. I know these little details are small, but it's all really simple. Okay, so let's go on now, and we're gonna go on to the creek, and we're going to build up the bank, just like we did here with the roof, and we just do that with a blue line, and just come along the side, just like this. And over here in the back, you know, under here, we're going to do the same thing by building up that snowy bank. As it's coming around. And we can start to see this little snowy bank here as well. And then on this side, we're just going to see the water, okay? Because we can't see the bank on this side of the creek. And just keep going in here. You know, underneath here is going to be dark. So here we go again with that shadow. So I want to make sure that shadow is underneath here. These little things make a big difference when your eye is looking at it to see if it's realistic. And we got to have that shadow in there. So let's go on now and do these little rocks. And you're going to see this color come out. Now, these are domes. Okay, so these are different than these. So the highlight is in the center of these because the contour is in the front. These are domes. So the highlight is at the top. It's at the top. You know, it's simple little things. And you know what? If you remember the rules, you're going to be really happy with how this turns out. And you know what? The more that you do it, the more that you get your confidence, the more amazed and impressed with yourself you will be. And you know, when you get your confidence, that's when these projects become fun. They're not meant to be stressful. And if you take something out and you start working on it and then you're not happy with it and you're just, it's very stressful. And I don't ever want you to think, why in the world did I ever buy that stamp set? I want you to think, why in the world didn't I buy that other stamp set too? That's what I want you to think. I don't want you to ever be frustrated that you bought something and you're not happy with how it works. And that's part of the reason I do so many of these videos and tutorials for you. I want you to be successful and I want you to see how easy it is. Okay, so let's get this water in. You know, leave some white spaces. You know, always try not to color everything in solid. And then down below, so you can see how that little bank now is really being built up here. And I'm still doing all of this with my number four brush. I am a simple tools person. I really am. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Now I'm going to take my fine tip again with the rocks, and I'm going to put my dark color in to the crevices. It's just a little tiny bit of color right where you see these rocks connect. So let me just hold this up. See these little areas here where the rocks kind of come together, where you think that would be the darkest place? So if you're looking at the rocks, where do you think would be the darkest place? Like right here where they all kind of connect. That's the darkest area. And just get that fine tip in there and then do the same with the brown. Get this in there too. Just a little bit more. And then you can pull some of this color out. It's better to do this. It's better to ink the image and stamp it off and do this later than it is to get it too dark on the outline. So, you know, people have asked me, Why don't you just stamp it on here so that you have more color in the first place? And the reason for that is because we don't want the tops of the rocks to be too dark. We have to get this color in here in order to pull the color out of the lines, but we don't want these rocks to be too dark because you don't want to see an outline around something. And if you stamp this in here too dark, it's just going to look like a round circle with the border around it. So it's really, really important to try to make these things look natural. And to me, this is the easiest way. And I think you're going to be successful every time you do it. Especially if you just learn these little, just these little shortcuts, these little tricks. And now you can take some of this color out because, you know, it's at the bottom where it would be the darkest, not at the top where the highlight would be. So you never want to color any of these rocks in solid. You always want to see this highlight, these highlights on the top. So you can see that. See where those are. So it's starting to get there, you guys. Okay, so let's go on now and let's put in some of this background. So I'm gonna use my pencil and I'm just gonna put in a couple of little lines here like this, you know, where this would go into the background. And then maybe just another little hill in here like this. And then we can use our little foliage in the background. So here's that little border foliage. I just love this thing so much. It works great. And we're gonna stamp this in now and kind of outline this little hill back here. And I just inked that with the dark blue. And now I'm gonna dip my brush, pinch it off, and I'm gonna come underneath here just with a straight line. And then just coarse soften all these little lines. Leave some white on there so they don't look like they're all colored in solid. And then we're gonna take some of this color, you know, and pull it out so it just looks like a little shadow here. Just pull some of that out. And then I'm gonna just put in a little hill in here. And then now we need to deal with this doorway. So we've got to have a road coming through here somewhere. So we're just gonna take our brush and just put a little road in. Nothing to it. Remember how to build this up? So you need to build that up just like that, and then a little darker here on the path. And then once it kind of gets inside here, it's going to be a little darker. And then the road can just kind of continue on out this way. And then let's just show a little light here in the background. And I'm just going to do this a little bit different. I'm just going to put some streaks in here that look more like shadows. You know, when you're looking outside, you see a snowy hill and you can just see the shadow of the clouds, you know, on that hill. So we can keep this, you know, in the background. We can keep this pretty simple. So I'm going to get my my masking fluid on here and get my tree into the background. So I'm going to ink my little snowy tree, this one, and I'm going to ink it with the dark blue, and I'm going to really stamp it off. So I'm going to use my positioner first. Place my little shield in here. If you guys don't have one of these, this is such a great investment. They're not super expensive, and I use mine all the time. All the time. So now you can see exactly where you wanna place this little tree. And this is gonna be a good spot right there. So first though, I wanna make sure that I stamp it off so that I get the majority of ink. I just wanna see a very light outline of this. And I think that's good right there. Actually, maybe we'll just drop it down a little bit. And stamp it in here very lightly, just so that we have a pattern. That's really what we're going for. We just want a pattern so that we don't go off base here with the tree just going everywhere. So I'm gonna use my Molotov now. And I'm gonna add some masking fluid to this. Now think about, you know, here's another reason why I use this tree is so that you can see how the snow is kind of mounded on the top. And that's really where you wanna follow the line with the masking fluid. So the first thing you wanna do is just kind of pump this and make sure you're getting the fluid out. And think about the masking fluid on the top of the tree. You know, as it comes around like this, you know, where the snow would be kind of mounded up. You know, on the tops of the branches. So if the snow is coming down, you know, as it's coming down, it's gonna kind of be mounded up like this. And you can just put as much on here as you want. So it's gonna kind of just look like that. So think about it as it's, you know, as you're doing this tree, you know, as the snow is coming down onto the branches, kind of mounded up like this. Just like that. And while we're at it, let's just go through and just do some little snow here in the background. Gonna add some little snowflakes coming down. in the background. Okay, so let's add some more detail in here while we're waiting for this masking fluid to dry. And I'm gonna just put in some of these little trees. And I'm just gonna use the blue, dark blue. Now this is where I would use the little tree from the new set if I had it, but I don't, so I'm just gonna use this one, and it works fine. And then maybe just part of the tree here. See if I can get that in there without touching the masking fluid. So you can see. Now with these, you want to make sure that you have a little shadow. So we're just gonna take a little bit of the blue, and we're just gonna come from the base and just really simply make a little shadow here. And you see how that just changes, you know, the look? See how that just changes that and makes it look a little more realistic? And obviously, it doesn't matter that I didn't do this exactly like the tree. It's just the idea of it. You know, the shadow is coming through here. You're gonna see the branches, and you know, you're just gonna see a little shadow here. So it doesn't, you know, matter if it's perfect. And I'm just gonna just get a little darker color here along the side. While we're waiting for all of this to dry. And I'm gonna just go darker under here. And you can see how that just kind of turns, that little creek just kind of turns. And then let's just kind of go around here. I don't like things that just end like this. You know, you want to kind of continue this little line here so that it doesn't look like it's a stamped image. And so let's put in, while we're still waiting, let's put in this little dried branch here. We're just going to stick it right into the snow like this. And I'm just going to use the brown. You know, because everything's dead. So we don't want to use any green in here. And I think I'll just put it in here like this, and maybe one more. And then we want to have a little shadow again. Just like that, into the background. And I think I'm just gonna add another, this looks too uniform to me. So I'm just gonna add another little something here. You know, don't be afraid to add, you know, some more details. You know, if you think you haven't stamped it correctly or you're not happy with how it looks, just take your fine tip and just add a few more little things in here. You can totally do that. And now I brought this down a little bit, so I'm just gonna make another little shadow here like that. And I think that looks pretty good. And I think this is about dry, so you can tell because that masking fluid really changes colors. So you can see how that is now dry. So I'm going to use my little fur bow here, this one, and I'm going to start out by just stamping this. So I did this on the YouTube tutorial, and I think it's really helpful. So let me show you how to stamp the foliage on here, because by the time you've got all this masking fluid on here, it's really hard to see how to stamp this. So let me show you how it goes. So I'm going to ink it in the dark green. And I'm going to start at the top, so like this, and then out to the side. And then you could just keep coming down and around like this. And just turn your page like this, and then come around like this. And so you got your little tree in here just like that. So it's really nice to have this pattern because you can see exactly where that's going. Okay, so I hope that was helpful. And that's what we're gonna do on here. We're gonna use the same green and same foliage, and we're just gonna come around like this. So there's the top, And now we're getting the sides in. And just turning this, you know, as you go. Same over here. And you're getting a lot of color now into the center, which is good. It's really good. And then down under here, just like that. So got a little tree in, and now we can add the water to it. Dip your brush, pinch it off. And you know, these little limbs that are on the outside, you know, you don't want to add too much water to those because we don't want to stretch them out too far. And we still want to see the texture. So I want to see that this is a fir tree. And just pinch your brush off and just add this, add the water to the green. So cute. And then we'll put a little shadow under this as well. And then while we're kind of letting that dry a little bit, I'm going to take some of this blue and just put a little sky in here in the background. Just like this. Just get a little bit of that sky in the background. Okay, so now I think this is dry enough that we can take this off. Let me just make sure. Just rub it off with your finger. And just take that off. You can also use an eraser to take this off. That will also work. So there's our little snowy tree. We've got this in here. So now what we want to do is just come underneath this and just put a little blue line underneath. So again, the idea of the dome and the contour, you know, where we've got a little shadow underneath. So not on the top, just on the bottom. So I'll hold that up so you can see. So you see that detail on there. Just under the very, very bottom. Now you could put some little, you know, ornaments on here. That would be so cute. Some little berries, just whatever you want to put on here. And then let's just add a little shadow underneath. Just like that. And I think we are getting close to being done. We just need to add the little bird on. I'm just gonna take this masking fluid off now so we can see the snow in the background. So we just need to add the little bird on here, and I think we are about finished with this project. Here it is, and of course we're gonna use the positioner on here. And I'm gonna use the dark brown and stamp it off. Really stamp it off because we do not want this little guy to be too dark. So I'm gonna use my little plexiglass plate here. And then just place this right into the center and put him right here on the edge. And make sure he's in the white area. You know, you're really gonna highlight this little bird. So you don't want it to be, you don't want him to be hidden into the blue area. And there he is, so cute. So we're going to make sure that we see his little eye. He's got a tiny little eye and his little beak. And you can make this bird whatever color you want him to be. So on my sample, I made him red. So let's just do that, a little red bird. And I think, you know what? It's time to switch brushes. I'm gonna use my tiny little brush. I just saw a comment on here that says, have you thought about gifting this? I would love to gift this. Would anybody be interested in having this? I would love to do that. In fact, I can gift everyone that I make on the live. So if you want to have it, just write in the comments that you would like to have it, and we'll just do a little drawing at the end. It's a great idea. Okay, so here's our little red bird. He's so cute. And actually, you could just put a little notch on his head, make him look like a little cardinal. You know, these little things, they're so tiny that they don't take a lot at all. And then I'm just going to add a little bit of color onto here. And maybe just with my brush, there we go, you guys. I think we are about finished with this. I think that turned out pretty good. It was super fun to do. Of course, I will sign and date because that is so important. And I hope you'll give this one a try. Now see, I'm actually think that this should even be darker under here. But try these larger, you know, images and try these combinations together because they are so much fun. And I just love inspiring you to try different things. It's my favorite thing. You know, these little trees too, you know, don't be afraid to add a few other little things on here. You know, extend these little branches out or add a few more. You know, you can do that. I'm giving you permission. Okay, and that looks like that is a wrap. So, like I said, I hope you guys will try this. I'm going to switch my camera around and see if there are any questions that you guys have for me. Okay, I'm back. And let me check out my iPad here. Okay, I'd love to have it. Okay, you guys, I just leave a comment on here and we'll throw you into a drawing and I'll give you that sample. Love that idea. Anybody have a question on anything? Or anybody have a suggestion? So next week I am going to do the Southwest. In fact, I told you what I was going to do. So here's the Southwest project I'm going to do next time. You know, I do these really detailed ones and then I go back to simple too. This is a really clean, simple project and you can do these really, really quickly. So I'm gonna take you through this tutorial next week on Watercolor Wednesday. So on YouTube, I'll be on YouTube next week and I'll show you how to put together something like this. Now you can use the same combination and of course use your, maybe use your fir boughs or make it more Christmassy, Northwest Christmassy. So, you know, with snow or maybe some fir boughs or something else. So I'll inspire you to try that. Would the bird have a shadow? You know, yes. I think it's so small. I really didn't put it on here, but if you're using a bigger bird, especially, yes, you would want to do that. Just make a little extra shadow onto there and show that. So a shadow, for some reason, makes all the difference. And it's such a simple little thing to do. Just, you know, practice a little bit. You know, with these things, these combinations of things, just stamp the branch a few times and practice putting a shadow under there so that when you do put a composition together like that, you will have a little bit of practice. Okay, how would you do icicles? You know, that is a really good question. I'm not sure how I would do icicles, but I'm sure we could figure it out. You know what? It would have to be a probably a larger structure. And maybe we would stamp the roof, maybe just not leave the edge of the roof, and we might have to do some hand drawing, but you know what? I'll think about that, Ruthann. That's a really good question. What paper am I using? I'm using Canson. Canson is my paper of choice. It's a blue tablet. You'll see it on Watercolor Wednesday, you know, in the supplies I'm using, there's always a picture of it. It's a blue tablet. It's 140 pound cold press. And I love it because it's a very consistent as far as texture goes. You can't have something that's too textured because these stamps are really, really tiny, really tiny. And you might lose those lines. So, okay, you guys, thank you so much. Be sure to tune in for Claire's big, big announcement on Friday. So be sure you are checking that out.
And check me out next week. I'll be on YouTube with that project, Southwest Project. Where would you start your bird shadow? Right in the branches. So somebody just said, where would you start the bird shadow? Right in the branches, right where it would be, right at the end of the branch. Have you done a sheep on? No, I haven't, but I sure can. Learn something every time you're on. Okay, that is my goal. That just made my day. Thank you so much, Roberta, for saying that, because I always think about that when I do a project. What am I teaching you that's new? What am I teaching you that you can learn, that you can take and use for other projects? So, all right, you guys, thanks so much for joining me. Thanks for hanging out with me this Wednesday morning. I love it so much, and I appreciate your support so much, and I will see you all again.